Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to discuss about introduction to neural networks. Ivan Gomez says our first goal for these neural networks or models is to achieve human level accuracy. Until you get to that level, you always know you can do better. The agenda of today's session: introduction to neural networks, history of neural networks, types of neural networks in today's world, then artificial neural network technology, then some introduction about deep learning. Here, introduction to neural network. What is neural network? A neural network is either a system software or hardware that works similar to the task performed by neurons of human brain. Neural networks include various technologies like deep learning, machine learning as a part of artificial intelligence. Then the original goal of the neural network approach was to create computational system that could solve problems like a human brain. However, over time, researchers shifted their focus to using neural networks to match specific tasks, leading to deviations from a strictly biological approach. Then, a human brain is not capable of solving complex data and cannot extract information from compound structures. To overcome this lack of ability to resolve complex problems, Warren and Walter in 1943 came up with a mathematical neural network called artificial neural networks. Nowadays it's called as ANN. The ANN is a computing system designed to replicate the way of human and analyze work. ANN is the key tool for machine learning. Then the pre-processing of multiple data input is done by different machine learning algorithms. These algorithms work together under a single framework called a neural network. Then there is a history of neural network. This is a since then neural networks have supported diverse tasks, including nowadays computer vision, speech recognition and machine translation, social network filtering, playing board and video games, and the important one is medical diagnosis by using this neural network. Then as structured and unstructured data sizes increases to big data levels, people's developed deep learning algorithms. Then which are essentially neural networks with many layers. Here the one of the important technology along with this neural networks is the deep learning. Deep learning enables the capture and mining of more and bigger data, including unstructured data. Then the small introduction about neural network. That is, what is meant by neural network? A neural network is nothing more than a bunch of neurons connected together. These are the neuron. For example, you take it as two input neuron. What is meant by neuron? What is the definition of neuron? The basic unit of a neural network, a neuron. Neuron takes inputs and does with some math with them and produces one output. Here this is an example for two input neuron. X1 and X2 is called as inputs. Y is our output. There are some mathematical functions are there. We are going to see. Then three things are happening here. First, each input is multiplied by a weight. Okay, this is called a W. W is represent weight 1. Each input having weights. For x1 input, it has weights W1. For x2 input, it has weight is W2. For first, each input is multiplied by a weight. For x1, is multiplied with input value x1 and also multiplied the value of weight. Then second, all the weighted inputs are added together with a bias, with some bias. What is a letter indicates here? B. x1 into W1 plus x2 into W2 plus B. The all weighteds are added together with this bias B. Then finally, you find the output. For what is output? Y is a function f. Then function of this one. There is a x1 into W1. This function f of this one. The function of f. This is called your activation functions. The activation function is used to turn an unbounded input into an output that has a nice predictable form. A commonly used activation function is the sigmoid function. This is an important one function in neural network, is sigmoid function. Here another example, it for neural network always contains input layer and hidden layer and its output layer. Then this network has two inputs and one hidden layer output with two neurons. H1 and H2 is called as your hidden neurons and output neurons. This is how O1 is called as output neuron. The neural networks are inspired by the structure of biological neural networks in a human brain. There is an input neuron which acts as an interface for all the other neurons to pass the input. is used to pass the input. Also, there is an one output neuron which accepts all the output from the different neurons. A neural network can have any number of layers with any number of neurons in those layers. The hidden neurons, the important part of neural network is hidden layer. The hidden neuron connected between input and output to make neural network superior to most of the machine learning algorithms. The basic idea stays the same. The feed the input as inputs are input forward through the neurons in the network to get the outputs at the end. This is a multi-layer neuron. Previous one is a single neural network. It has only one hidden layer. If it is two hidden layers, means it's called your multi-layer neuron. This for also another example for deep learning networks. It has more number of hidden layers. This is called your deep learning network. For the simple neural network, bias and voltage is a concept for what is meant by bias, what is meant by weights. These are all input neurons, hidden layer 1, hidden layer 2, this output layer. Okay, here what is bias? Here bias is simply a constant value or a constant vector that is added to a product of your input and weights. Product of an input and weights, bias is utilized to offset the result. The bias is used to shift the result of activation function towards the positive or negative side. Then what are weights? When the neural network is trained on the training set, it is initialized with a set of weights. These weights are then optimized during the training period and optimum weights are produced. This is an example of neural network with two layer hidden neurons and then output and input and output layer. Each synapse has a weight associated with it. Then what is meant by learning algorithms in a neural network? Learning algorithms, what is meant by learning? So learning is the process by which weights and biases are adjusted to activate some desired network behavior. Then what is meant by learning process? The learning process of a neural network is performed with this input layer, hidden and output layers. The procedure used to carry out the learning process in a neural network is called as the optimization algorithm. It's an important one. Then there are many different optimization algorithms are there. Then all have different characteristics and performance in terms of memory requirements, processing speed and numerical precisions. There are some more important optimization algorithms are provided in MATLAB. What is the important optimization algorithms? Gradient descent method and Newton method and conjugate method and quasi-Newton method and Levenberg-Marquardt algorithm. Then the MATLAB provides neural network designer application to implement a great variety of optimization algorithm to ensure that you always achieve the best models from your data. Now then, why you are using neural networks? Then why are neural networks are important? Yeah, your neural networks are also ideally suited to help people solve complex problems in real time situations. As a result, neural networks can improve decision process in areas such as credit card and Medicare fraud detection, optimization of logistic in the transportation networks, then character voice recognition, that is also popularly known as natural language processing, then medical and disease diagnosis, computer vision to interpret raw photos and videos, for example in medical imaging and robotics and facial recognition, then financial prediction also available by using this neural network. Financial prediction for stock prices, currency, options and futures, bankruptcy and bond ratings. Then in robotics, robotic control systems, in electrical load and energy demand forecasting, process and quality control, chemical compound identification, ecosystem evaluation. These are all the important application in neural network. Then what are the different types of neural networks? There are different types of deep neural networks. Why it is called deep? Means here deep means many. Here many number of hidden layers is presented in neural networks called deep neural networks. There are different kinds of deep neural networks and each has advantages and disadvantages depending upon the use. For example, what are the examples include? There's a type of neural networks. First one is convolution neural network. This is called as CNN. The CNNs have also been applied to other areas such as natural language processing and forecasting. This the CNN networks is particularly used for natural language processing and forecasting. Then second type is recurrent neural networks. It's called as RNNs. The RNNs are used in forecasting and time series applications, sentiment analysis and other text application, text based application. We are using recurrent neural networks. For example, big data analytics, we are using recurrent neural networks. Then feed forward neural networks. It is a biologically inspired classification algorithm network, primarily used for supervised learning. Then the important one is autoencoder neural networks, used for unsupervised learning. Models are trained in large data sets. It's used for big data analysis. We are using autoencoder neural networks. Then neural networks in today's world. Neural networks are changing how people and organizations interact with systems, solve problems and make better decisions and predictions. Who uses neural networks? For example, health and life sciences organizations are users neural networks to enable predictive diagnostics, biomedical imaging and health monitoring. These are the more important neural networks used in today's world. Then energy and manufacturing companies are using neural networks to optimize supply chains, automate defect detections and forecast energy needs. Then banks are nowadays using neural networks to detect fraud, conduct credit card analysis and automate financial advisor services. Now the public sector's organizations use neural networks to support smart cities and security intelligence and facial recognition. These are all coming under security purpose. The communication and retail industry uses neural networks to power conversational chatbots and enhance and deepen customer intelligence and perform network analysis also. Then what is artificial neural network technology? Then once a network has been structured for a particular application, that network is ready to train. To start this process, the initial weights are chosen randomly. Then the training and learning and begins. There are two approaches to training the artificial neural networks. One is supervised training or supervised learning, and another one is unsupervised training. What is meant by supervised learning? Is a simply a process of learning algorithms from the training data set. This is a predefined training data set, is called as supervised learning. The supervised learning aim is to approximate the mapping function so that when we have new input data, we can predict the output variables for that data. Whereas by using unsupervised learning, the network is provided with inputs but not with the desired outputs. Here this is a common difference between supervised learning versus your unsupervised learning. Then in unsupervised learning, the network provided with inputs but not with desired outputs, because unsupervised learning does not use output data. Here supervised learning aim is to model the hidden patterns or underlying the structure in the given input data in order to learn output data. Then some small introduction to deep learning. The traditional artificial neural network method suffered from problems such as overfitting and diminishing gradients and thus just a few researchers were working on them in 90s. Then Joshua, who are the father of deep learning. The deep learning is a powerful set of techniques for learning in neural networks. The neural networks and deep learning currently provide the best solution to many problems in image recognition, speech recognition and natural language processing. Next session we are going to discuss about introduction to deep learning. Thank you.